Yeah, but Jericho has to get by Regal. And Regal is British. And as he said, the British are the most barbaric people in the history of mankind. And I must say, they also make the finest commissioners in the history of the World Wrestling Federation.
I would tend to agree with the first part of your statement, but that second part, I don't know about, Paul. But in any event, William Regal's been looking, Regal, looking to end this thing early. And who says that's not a bad way to go out? Get out, you win.
That's why he's the commissioner. He makes very difficult decisions like that.
Regal, certainly considered by many a very political commissioner, acquiescing to virtually every demand, request, or suggestion by Mr. McMahon, his daughter Stephanie, the WWF champion and the Intercontinental champion, it seems.
Pretty good way to get some job security around here, huh?
Well, it's working for the time being for Commissioner Regal. There's a knockdown by Jericho, and Jericho cannot be asleep at the wheel and allow Regal to step out that door. Quite the drop kick, bringing Commissioner Regal back in. Now Jericho's got some time and opportunity to climb over the top, but Regal trying to desperately hold on to that ankle as Jericho now up on top. This one may be over quicker than we thought. Regal's got a handful of Jericho's hair and follows those headbutts right to the temple of Y2J.
And that's the way to knock a man's equilibrium out of order. And if you don't have equilibrium and you can't stand, you can't.
Oh, man!
Jericho all the way down. And now Regal, who had a chance to escape, over the top decides to walk right past Jericho out the door.
Regal's got this match won. It's...
He's gonna punish Jericho.
That must be the MO here of William Regal. Now that he has a decided advantage, comes with those stiff left foot feet. One left and one right.
European uppercut by the physical commissioner, William Regal. Please go ahead after you, sir.
I'm sorry.
In the name of the commissioner, I yield to your courtesy.
Regal, another uppercut. And I don't know if they come back to home, Regal. Jericho scoring with a forearm, using the rope for additional momentum. And now Jericho trying to go back up and over the top. This is what got him in trouble to start with. And it is continuing to get Chris Jericho in trouble. And this match with no pinfalls and no disqualifications. Jericho face first into the steel cage. And we'll have a little give, that cyclone fencing, but not much.
The commissioner does not appreciate being called an ass clown, nor can I blame him.
Oh, what is an ass clown?
I personally don't know. I'll have to look that one up later.
Jericho finds himself between the cage and the ropes, and now his face being raked by Commissioner Regal, and Regal's got to be loving this. Wow, what a shot that was.
The commissioner is taking Jericho apart piece by piece, limb from limb. And he's making Jericho pay for all of Y2J's insubordination and disrespect.
Regal's got a lethal left hand, to say the least, and it's found its mark on several occasions now. Chris Jericho, and unless Regal makes a big, big mistake here, one has to assume that he is firmly in the driver's seat. But again, when you have the opportunity, Paul, sometimes to win it, and you don't, you never know what happens.
Yeah, but it looks to me like the commissioner has this match well in hand.
Steel cage here. Table still to come, in addition to Rikishi and Austin. And Jericho, who never says die, I'll tell you, looking over the, trying to get over the top. And again, Regal now, both men up on the top rope.
Man, those headbutts are brutal.
Both arms are hooked. And Regal with a suplex. Not only taking it out of Y2J, who landed abruptly on his hip, but taking it out of the commissioner as well.
Well, that's a maneuver that takes both people out. So watch this. The one employing the maneuver and the one... Jericho coming down hard, and I do mean hard, and the commissioner is the first to his feet.
Regal walking a little cockeyed, but the right hand buried deep in the midsection now. Jericho has so much resilience. We have seen Jericho in tough positions before. He's looking for the walls of Jericho, but remember, you can't win the match with that submission move. You can certainly debilitate your opponent, however. Another ride by Jericho. Jericho now seems to be building some momentum. As Regal, his face contorted more than normal, being really introduced to the steel cage. And now the commissioner, and this is not what he has envisioned in signing this match for himself.
No, not at all. Now Y2J taking out all his aggressions on the physical commissioner, William Regal. You'd think that Jericho would seize the opportunity and leave the cage while he can.
But much like the commissioner did earlier, now it's about punishing. It's about injury.
This is a deeply personal issue between these two. Jericho and Regal hate each other.
Nobody there from the Lion's Saw, as Commissioner William Regal had that maneuver well scouted, and now Regal perhaps with an opportunity to go out the door again. Now Regal's deciding that he's going to take the vertical path, and Regal now getting closer to the top.
He has a big lead on Jericho. Regal is way ahead right now.
Jericho back up, trying to grab that ankle. And there you see Regal sticking that foot in Jericho's face. As now both men sort of a little no man's land here. Heads bouncing off the steel. Something's got to give, and it won't be the steel.
And it won't be the top rope, and Regal is in a bad, bad way right now.
Regal landing in the worst place imaginable for him, I would assume.
And Jericho's leaving the cage! Jericho's up! Jericho's leaving the cage! The commissioner is down!
Jericho up on top! The cage door is open! Regal sees the door open! Jericho hanging on the top of the cage!
It's a race! It's a race!
Which one of these two superstars will get out first? Jericho trying to navigate his way down. Oh, God! Jericho just emphatically closed this chapter with a victory in this cage match. It looked as if Regal might pull him out at the end. Jericho, quite frankly, got a big break there and was able to slam the door shut, literally and figuratively, on the head of the commissioner.
Well, Y2J lucked out on this one. Fate was on his side. The commissioner was going to beat Jericho to the floor, but Y2J lands both feet into the door. The door against the head of William Regal.
Well, this is certainly barbaric. If the commissioner was looking for barbaric, that was barbaric. And Chris Jericho has prevailed here. But there still may be some hell to pay politically for Y2J somewhere down the road.